to BanjoBenClark.com. More importantly, Merry Christmas here at the site that teaches you how to play banjo, guitar. This week is Mandolin Week. We've kicked off the Christmas tunes for the year. We're going to learn Deck the Halls, and we're doing this in a build-a-break lesson format, which is probably my most popular format that I do because you learn so much. We're going to start with the basic melody, then we're going to learn how to add scale notes to create a more robust solo, and then about that time Granny's going to serve us some of her eggnog that she's so famous for, and we're going to come up with that third solo that has all those triplets and gets up the neck and lots of fun. If you're watching on YouTube or Facebook, here in a moment I'll ask you to come over to the website, BanjoBenClark.com. You can come over there, check out the rest of the lesson, hundreds of other ones. I have lots of Christmas stuff over there too for all three instruments. You can join as a Gold Peak member, have access to these hundreds of these lessons. This one's a 20 plus minute lesson. I've got the tab just like I played it. Then I have three different speeds of JamTrack, MP3s, and oh man, all kinds of great stuff. You need to check out the site, tons of features. Without any further ado, let's learn this basic melody to Deck the Halls in the key of G on mandolin. Deck the Halls on mandolin. We're going to do a build-a-break lesson in the key of G. These are a lot of fun, y'all. We're going to start off with this basic melody that anybody can learn. But then we're going to use that to build a second break that uses all kinds of scale notes. So I'm going to show you how to build a more robust break using scale notes. And then we're going to add some eggnog. And it might even be Granny's eggnog, but it's going to have all kinds of cool little triplets in it and get up the neck. So I'll show you how to do that when the time comes. Let's go ahead and throw up the first line of tab. A couple things you need to notice. One is I want you to pay attention to the pick stroke arrows beneath the notes. So down arrows is down, strokes up is up. We've got our chords above the tab there. These are my chords. They're pretty common, but you will find variations if you sniff around enough. Also, we're in 4/4 time. So there's four beats per measure, and we're in the key of G, as I mentioned, which is a pretty singable key. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, la 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 la. So we've got this very basic melody here, and I'm going to give you a pickup measure here in this first measure that you see. It's labeled measure two, but it comes in on the second beat, and just has three quarter notes, sounds like this. One, two, three, four. And then there in measure three, when we get on that fifth fret up here, that's the first note of the actual melody. The halls with bells. So when we get up there, that is a dotted quarter note. So that's going to get a beat and a half. So one and two and three and four and. Then we've got measure four is just full of quarter notes. Bells of holly. A few eighth notes here, measure five. And then again, just notice that dotted quarter note there, that second fret halfway through measure five, gets a beat and a half. Three and four and one. And then measure six, we got two quarter notes. One, two, three. And then that last fifth fret, measure six, you'll notice that the stem is broken. It's not solid. That means it's a half note, it's two beats. Let me play this first line for you really slow, and then, or pretty slow. We'll do it much slower later on. One, two, three, four. 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 And I have a tendency to kind of swing it a little bit. So you can express it however you want to, Mr. or Mrs. We look at measure seven. We've got some repeating here because the melody repeats. We're going to keep it very basic for now. So we've already seen this. That's just measures three through six all over again. Now as we get to measure 11, we get into a different part of the song. It's going to go to a D chord for a measure. And we're going to keep our melody here on this A string. And we've got some more dotted quarter notes here. So it's just important to count those. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Measure 13, we have some really cool chords happening in the background. If this is how you want to play it, you can have your guitar picking buddy play these chords. B minor sounds really nice here. And we're going to walk up using a couple eighth notes and land on the fifth fret. It sounds like this, which is getting out of the G scale, but it sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? And that's the melody. Second half of measure 13. And then walk down for the last measure. So this whole line. Three, four. Then we have some more repeating in measure 15. And then to wrap up the melody, go all the way up to the first string. One and two and three and four and one and two and three. And then the last beat there in measure 18 are just pickup notes into the next melody, the next solo that we're going to play. Let's check that out now.